read correctly. And we've been reading namaz for what, past 15, 20, 25 years. These are basic things, my dear son and brothers, that we need to wake up and make use of this time before it's too late. Sallu ala al-Habib, sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is a beautiful booklet that has been published by Maktabatul Madina, titled Hafidha Kaise Mazbutho, how to make your memory strong. This book, if you want to know the methods of strengthening your memory, I want to learn about the reasons that weaken your memory, then go and read this booklet. Hafidha Kaise Mazbutho. You can download this booklet free of charge. You can read it online, you can download it free of charge from www.da'watislami.net. Amir Ahl Sunnah Dawud Barakatuhu Aliya has narrated a virtue of Durood Sharif in the Madri Panj Surah. It is written in Madri Panj Surah that if a person has the illness of forgetting, he's got weak memory, then he should recite this Durood in abundance between Maghrib and Isha Salah. Beautiful Durood. Many narrations we hear almost every day. Whenever we come to the Dars, when we come to the Ijtima' on Thursdays, we hear many narrations. This one narration, particularly the Durood Sharif, has been mentioned in Madri Panj Surah on page 169. That whoever recites this Durood Sharif between Maghrib and Isha Salah, his memory will get stronger. So let's all recite this Durood to gain his blessings, inshallah. اللهم
اللهم
صل وسلم
صل وسلم
وبارك على
وبارك على
سيدنا
سيدنا
محمد
محمد
النبي
النبي
الكامل
الكامل
وعلى
وعلى
آله
آله
كما لا
كما لا
نهاية
لكمالك
وعدد كماله
وعدد كماله.
Beautiful Durood. Like I say, if you learning this Durood Sharif and you're struggling to remember this, to then the best thing to do is download the Madri Panj Surah or get it from one of the Maktabatul Madinas and read this Durood Sharif between Maghrib and Isha, inshaAllah Azza wa Jal. Through the blessings of this Durood Sharif, your memory will get stronger, inshaAllah. Sallu ala al-Habib, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear Islamic brothers, sacrificing life, wealth, family, and facing difficulties for the sake of Islam, it has been an old practice. It's not something new. Therefore, when the Prophets, alayhimus salam, the noble companions, alayhim rudwan, pious predecessors, rahimahumullah, and the scholars of Islam, they started the work of propagating Islam, they started inviting people towards Islam, then their life did not become easy. They were not greeted with flowers. Rather, in return of this favor, they were subject to cruelty and tyranny. They were severed by swords, they were imprisoned and locked up. Their skins were even peeled off from their bodies. Their bare backs were whipped. They were made fun of. They were exiled from their own cities. They were thrown into boiling oil. They were dragged on scorching sand. Their bodies were riddled with arrows, swords, and spears. And some even attained martyrdom in this cause. In short, these pious people bore so many difficulties for the sake of Islam that when we hear about them, our bodies begin to tremble. Every strand of our hair stands on end. Our heart becomes saddened and tears begin to flow from our eyes. The leader of millions of families, Imam Ahmad bin Hamad rahmatullah ta'ala, is also included in the list of those noble awliya rahmatullah ta'ala, who gave so many sacrifices for the sake of Islam and also had to endure different types of severe difficulties in the way of Allah. once, upon the order of Abbasid Khalifa, Mu'tasim Billah, the executioners, they start to whip the back of Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahmatullah ta'ala, turn by turn.
Allah.
Due to this punishment, due to this severe punishment, he would faint. But before he would faint, he would say that I have forgiven the crime of Mu'tasim Billah, the ruler of that time, upon whose orders this great personality, this wali of Allah, was being punished. Later on, when people asked the Imam the reason for this, why would you forgive that person upon whose orders you are being punished? He would say that Mu'tasim Billah is a descendant of Sayyidina Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Who's Sayyidina Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu? He's the uncle of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, I feel ashamed in case it is announced on the Day of Judgment that Ahmad bin Hanbal did not forgive the descendant of the uncle of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. SubhanAllah. Sayyidina Fuzail bin Iyad rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi stated that Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi was imprisoned for consecutive 28 days. During this period, he used to be lashed every night until he fainted. He was wounded with swords and trampled upon. But what can be said about this? His steadfastness. He remained steadfast despite facing an onslaught of calamities. Sallu ala al-Habib. Sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear son, brothers, we've just heard the famous muhaddith and wali, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal rahmatullah ta'ala alayhi. He was inflicted with so much difficulties, but he never cried about it. He never screamed or shouted. He never complained or grieved. He was never impatient and he was never unthankful. Rather, he remained patient, content, and he remained happy upon the will of Allah azza wa jal. That this is the mercy of Allah azza wa jal. This is his rida. And as a bondman, we have to say labbaik. He rahmatullah ta'ala knew that the calamities and the tests that are befalling upon him, they are a means of mercy of Allah azza wa jal. Allah azza wa jal intends goodness with a person afflicted with calamities. The sins of the person afflicted with calamities are forgiven. Allah Azza wa Jalla grants without count to the person facing a test. Good news of forgiveness from the court of Allah Azza wa Jalla is given to the person who hides his calamities. And we need to learn many lessons from this. Whenever we go through some bad patch, we would like to mention it to everybody. It has become our habit. We want everybody to know that we are going through some bad times now. It's kind of a self-pity. But when we are going through some good times, do we also make sure that everybody finds out about this? We take those good times for granted. But a minor hiccup, a bad patch, and all of a sudden we think the world has fallen upon us. But if you are patient, if you take this as a will of Allah Azza wa Jal, then through this, you can only gain the closeness of Allah Azza wa Jal. And through this, your sins will be forgiven, inshaAllah. Sallu ala al-Habib. Sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear Islam brothers, Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal, the Madri movement of the devotees of the Prophet Dawud Islami spreading the message of Islam in more than 108 departments all across the
world.
One of those departments is the education department. Let's listen a brief introduction to this department and the works of this department. Every wise person knows that the development and the fall of nations is dependent upon the upbringing of the younger generation. The generation that will take over in the future. Today, the quality of our education system, the condition of our institutions, and the structure of our education and training is extremely pitiful. Islamic upbringing is almost non-existent. With this purpose in mind, the Madani movement of the devotees of the Prophet Dawud Islami has established the Department of Education to spread sunnahs, whose main purpose is to give all the students and people associated with the this Madani environment a mindset to spend their lives according to sunnah. Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal, with the intention, with good intentions, this department builds a good relationship with the teachers and students of college and universities, and teaches them the sunnahs of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Alhamdulillah, up until now, numerous students have repented from their sins, started to offer salah, and act upon the sunnah. May Allah Almighty grant the Department of Education more success. Ameen. Bijahi Nabi Al-Ameen sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Inshallah Azza wa Jal, we'll now go through the 6 duruds and 2 du'as that are recited in the Sunnah inspired by Mustafa al-Islami every week. The saints of Islam have quoted that whoever recites this durood at least once on the night preceding Friday, i.e. the night between Thursday and a Friday on a regular basis, he will be blessed with the vision of the beloved and blessed Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at the time of death, as well as the time of his burial into the grave, to the extent that he will see the noble Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lowering him into the grave with on merciful hands. Let's all recite together. Allahumma,
Allahumma,
salli wa sallim,
salli wa sallim,
wa
barik ala
Sayyidina,
Sayyidina
Muhammadin,
Muhammadin,
al-Nabiyyi,
al-Nabiyyi,
al-Ummiyyi,
al-Ummiyyi,
al-Habibi,
al-Habibi,
al-Ali,
al-Ali,
al-Qadri,
al-Qadri,
al-Azimi,
al-Azimi,
al-Jah,
al-Jah,
wa'ala,
wa'ala,
al-Ali,
وصحبه
وسلم. The saints of Islam. It is narrated by Sayyidina Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu that the beloved and blessed Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has stated, whoever recites this durood upon me while standing, then prior to his sitting back, and if he recites it while he is sitting, and before he stands back, his sins will be forgiven. Allahumma,
Allahumma,
salli ala
Sayyidina
wa Mawlana
Muhammadin
wa ala
alihi
wa sallim.
Whoever
recites this dawood, 70 portals of mercy are open for him.
Sallallahu ala Muhammad.
Sallallahu ala Muhammad.
Sheikh Ahmed Sadi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi reports from some saints of Islam that the one reciting this durood once receives the reward of reciting durood 600,000 times. Allahumma,
Allahumma,
salli ala
Sayyidina
Muhammadin,
Muhammadin,
adada,
adada,
ma fi,
ilmillahi,
ilmillahi,
salatan,
salatan,
daimatan,
daimatan,
bidawami,
bidawami,
mulkillah,
mulkillah. One day somebody came into the court of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, and the noble Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made that person sit in between himself and Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The respected companions, they were surprised as to who that honored person was. When he had left, the beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that when he recites the ruud upon me, he does so in these words. اللهم
اللهم
صل
على
محمد
محمد
كما تحب
كما تحب
وترضى له
وترضى له.
The greatest Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam stated, the one who recites this durood upon me, my intercession will become wajib for you.
Subhanallah.
Allahumma.
Allahumma.
Salli ala.
Salli ala.
Muhammadin.
Muhammadin.
Wa anzilhu.
Wa anzilhu.
Al-maq'ada.
Al-maq'ada.
Al-muqarraba.
Al-muqarraba.
Indaka.
Indaka.
Yawm al-qiyamah.
Yawm al-qiyamah.
It is narrated by Sayyidina Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, that the noble Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam stated, for the reciter of above supplication, 70 angels write good deeds for 1,000 days. Jazallahu
Jazallahu
Anna
Anna
Muhammadan
Muhammadan
Ma huwa
Ma huwa
Ahlu
Ahlu.
The Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, if anyone recites the following dua 3 times a night, it is as if he has found Laylatul Qadr. This is the dua. La ilaha illallah.
La ilaha illallah.
Al-Halimul Kareem.
Al-Halimul Kareem.
Subhanallah.
Subhanallah.
Rabbis Samawati.
Rabbis Samawati.
As-Sab'i.
As-Sab'i.
Wa Rabbil Arshil Azim.
Wa Rabbil Arshil Azim.
La ilaha illallah.
La ilaha illallah.
Al-Halimul Kareem.
Al-Halimul
سبحان الله
سبحان الله
رب السماوات
رب السماوات
السبع
السبع
ورب العرش العظيم
ورب العرش العظيم
لا إله إلا الله
لا إله إلا الله
الحليم الكريم
الحليم الكريم
سبحان الله
سبحان الله
رب السماوات
رب السماوات
السبع
السبع
ورب العرش العظيم
ورب العرش العظيم
صلوا على الحبيب
صلى
الله تعالى على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Just a few announcements. As you know, the weekly Ijtima for the Islamic Brothers takes place in this Faizan Medina every Thursday after Salatul Isha, 8 o'clock. Similarly, the gathering for Islamic Sisters takes place in various places. Sundays, this Faizan Medina, and also Village Street Masjid. And on Wednesdays, it's the Ikhlas Center on Clarence Road. It's important, very important, to also send the sisters of our household to learn the Islamic knowledge. Because remember, our children spend more time with their mothers than they do with us, because we're mostly out. So it's important that the sisters also know the Islamic upbringing of their children as well, inshallah. And also the monthly Madani Qafla that travels every month in the way of Allah Azza wa Jal to gain the Islamic knowledge, to learn the Sunnah of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is also traveling tomorrow, inshallah. Tomorrow, Friday, from this very Faizan Medina, it is a humble request. Please take out some time from your daily life, from your busy schedule. We feel sometimes that if we're not here, if we're not going to do something, the world will stop. You know, our household things will never get done. This is not the case. You look around you. How many important people that we used to know that are not here anymore? The world just carries on. Things will happen, okay? Think about your akhirah. Think about the time that we have in this world. Make use of this. It is narrated that whoever travels in the way of Allah Azza wa Jal and with the intention of gaining Islamic knowledge, he is a student of Islamic knowledge. And even the fishes in the seas, they do istighfar for that person. And the angels, they cover with their wings that person. It's a great status to be a seeker of knowledge. So make this intention. We leave on Friday, tomorrow inshallah, about 6:30, 7 o'clock. It's going to Coventry, and it'll be back on Sunday. So it's hardly 48 hours. And if you've never traveled in the Madani Qafla before, the transport is provided, the food is provided, we stay in the masjid, all the comfort you will get, inshallah. But in addition, you will learn some useful knowledge, inshallah. So make this intention to give your name at the end of this gathering and be part of this Bani Kaaba, inshallah. Sallu ala al-Habib, inshallah, there will be now dhikr, dua, salatu salam at the end. So humble request to stay till the end, inshallah.
صلوا على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ایک اور اعلان سنیں گے کہ ذات تعالی کے واسطہ ہو انشاءاللہ ہفتے میں تین دن ادا کریں گے ایک اجتماع کے بعد اور ایک جمعہ والے دن جمعہ کی نماز کے بعد اور ایک اتوار والے دن ایک سے لے کے دو بجے تک یعنی ظہر کے ٹائم کے وقت میں ذات تعالی دیا جائے گا اور طویزات جو ہے انہیں تین ٹائموں کے وقت دیے جائیں گے ان کے علاوہ طویز جو ہے وہ نہیں دیے جائیں گے تین ٹائم ہوں گی ہفتے میں اجتماع کے بعد جمعے کے بعد اور اتوار والے دن ظہر کی نماز کے بعد یہ اسلام بھائی ٹائم جو ہے نوٹ کر لیجیے انشاءاللہ آج بھی جو ہے اجتماع کے بعد طویزات ادارے کی ترکیب ہوگی تو جن اسلام بھائی کو طویز چاہیے ہو وہ اجتماع کے بعد پیچھے مکتب میں تشریف لے جائیں صلوا
صلى الله تعالى
میٹھے میٹھے اسلام بھائی سے ایک اعلان رہ گیا کہ انشاءاللہ عزوجل اگلا جو آنے والا جمعرات ہے انشاءاللہ عزوجل مفتی عبد النبی حمیدی صاحب جو ساؤتھ افریقہ سے تشریف لے کے ان کا بیان ہوگا انشاءاللہ تو عام اسلام بھائی سے مدنی التجا ہے کہ آپ نے خود بھی شرکت کرنی ہے اور بھرپور دعوت دے کے دینا دوسرے اسلام بھائی کو ساتھ لے کے
آئیے میرے میٹھے اور پیارے اسلام بھائیوں گنبد خضرا کا تصور جمعہ سے مل کر ایک آواز میں جا رہے ہیں اور اپنا دعا کرتے ہیں الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله الصلاة
لا إله إلا الله Allah